Previously on Hell's Kitchen.
The person I'm going to eliminate tonight is going downhill.
After a surprising elimination.
Jamie, you're done. Jack it off, please.
Told you I wasn't going home.
The red team is left reeling.
What happened?
I am in shock.
I'm still here.
Then the teams went head-to-head in the blind taste test.
Strawberry?
What?
Sardines?
Which proved challenging for everyone.
Mushrooms? Lobster?
Except for Elise.
Filet? Coconut? Sour cream?
Red team wins!
Who gave the red team a come-from-behind victory.
Woo!
Thank you.
You're welcome, red team. You're welcome.
During steak night at Hell's Kitchen, the blue team was in the kitchen for the first seating.
How you doing, Tommy?
Tommy was silent.
He's not even talking, this guy.
Tommy, how long?
You need to talk to him.
All three of you are watching him sink.
And Natalie's meat station was a hot mess.
I didn't realize it was that overdone, Chef.
Wake up!
At the second seating.
You write like a 9-year-old. Come on!
Pick it up.
When the red team took their turn in the kitchen.
Hurry up, let's go.
Yeah, I'm gonna need 2 minutes.
Their strong start.
Nice. That's called working as a team.
Quickly deteriorated.
Raw bass. Unbelievable. That's burnt.
And then it was time for the blame game.
When no one else would step up and I did.
Shut up for 5 fucking seconds.
Both teams lost and had to nominate one person. The red team nominated it.
Carrie, Chef.
And the blue team chose.
Tommy, Chef.
But in the end, it was.
Carrie.
Who saw her dream of becoming head chef at BLT Steak in New York City come to an end. But Chef Ramsay.
We're not done yet.
Shocked everyone once again.
Elise.
Fuck me.
Take your jacket off.
Continuation of Hell's Kitchen.
I've been thinking long and hard, and I've come to a decision. Elise, take your jacket off. I know you think you're ready, but you're not. In fact, none of you are ready. All of you, take your jackets off. As from right now, Hell's Kitchen is closed.
What?
I'm still not convinced that you have that drive to become the head chef at BLT Steak. You have to get inspired. So you're all flying to New York City first thing tomorrow morning to see BLT Steak firsthand.
Are you kidding me?
You shitting me?
If that doesn't light a fire in your bellies, I don't know what will. You understand?
Yes, Chef.
Get out of here. Get bags packed. You're leaving early.
I'm gonna have my eye on the prize, believe you me. And not just my lazy eye, my good eye.
I'm going to New York.
Ah! Big Apple.
Woo!
Paul's hitting New York City.
As part of his master plan, Chef Ramsay has arranged for the chefs to experience the culinary crossroads of the world.
I'm Raheem.
Paul.
I'm your Foods of New York tour guide.
With a tasting tour of the Big Apple.
Let's go eat.
First up, Italian.
We can't come to New York City without hitting up the best pizzeria.
Oh, Chef. Clam pie for you to start with, all right?
Oh, my God. Let me tell you something about clam pie. Off the chain delicious.
Excellent.
Put it up then.
Next up on the tour, Chinese.
The key to making Peking duck is you inflate the duck.
Okay, enjoy your duck.
That's so good.
Rick, what's up next?
French.
Will, what do you think of that foie gras? Isn't that amazing?
I mean, the food is so good. I'm trying to pace myself. I should probably eat one.
Oh.
Greek.
Are we diving in?
These are so good.
This is so my favorite. Mm. Oh, my God.
Mexican.
Oh. Carnitas?
I feel a little beast.
Jamaican.
Shaba.
Holy moly.
Got like a little spice to it.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
Indian.
I couldn't ask for anything more in a 13th, 14th course, you know? You guys like it?
So good.
I couldn't do any more.
Are you guys ready for more?
No!
All right.
After feasting on the fabulous flavors of New York, the chefs head to BLT for a taste of what's at stake.
Ooh.
This is nice.
I know, this is gorgeous.
Hi, welcome to BLT Steak.
Hi.
Before I take you into the kitchen, let me give you a quick tour of the restaurant.
Okay.
Thank you.
So this is the main dining room.
Wow.
This is beautiful. The heart of the restaurant.
It's beautiful. I'm definitely picturing myself there, and it made me that much more determined to have that head chef spot.
So this is the kitchen?
This is amazing.
Okay.
This is a large kitchen in comparison to a lot of Manhattan kitchens.
What would you say would be the hardest thing to adjust to somebody who hasn't worked in New York?
The biggest challenge for someone who has not worked a New York kitchen is the pace. We're gonna do between 230 and 250 covers every single night.
When I close my eyes, all I imagine is myself standing at that pass. Like, everything now is coming full circle. The next time I step foot in a BLT restaurant, it's gonna be me with my white coat and my hat. And they're gonna say, congratulations, Paul. Welcome to the team.
Thank you guys for coming out. I wish you all the best of luck.
Thank you.
If Chef Ramsay was trying to light a fire under our asses and to get us, like, motivated, this trip definitely did its job. Woo! I'm ready to go all the way and to become head chef at BLT Steak.
After a whirlwind tour of New York City, the chefs return reinvigorated.
What's this?
And ready to take on their next challenge.
Look at you all. Welcome back.
Hey.
Thank you, Chef.
So, did you get inspired?
Yes, Chef.
Motivated?
Yes, Chef.
Hungry?
No, Chef.
Jennifer?
Yes, Chef.
Did you enjoy it?
It was amazing. It reminded me why I'm here.
Good. You all had opportunity to taste some of the finest cuisines from anywhere in the world, which brings me to your next challenge. Today, I want to see how creative you can all be with ethnic cuisine. I hope in New York, you picked up some tips.
What? Are you serious? We tried 7 different cuisines, but the problem is I was just not paying attention.
Excited?
Yes, Chef.
Good, because right now, each and every one of you is about to gamble your future in Hell's Kitchen.
Oh, my goodness.
Excellent. Woo! That's right.
It's fucking crazy, dude.
As far as gambling, I've never been real lucky.
Listen carefully, one at a time. Each chef will come forward. After you pull the handle, the 5 slots you land on will determine the ingredients. What protein, what starch, what fruit and 2 vegetable you'll be cooking with. Also, a coin will come out. The coin determines the type of cuisine. Who's feeling lucky? Natalie, step forward.
You got him, girl.
Come on, Nat.
Okay, pull the handle. Pork. With corn. Potatoes.
Kumquats.
Ooh, and green beans. And the ethnic cuisine is?
Jamaican.
Wow. Oh,
no. I had some tricky ingredients.
Okay. Basically, good luck.
I was just hoping that I could pull something together.
Okay, next up, Jennifer.
Great.
Let's go.
I feel lucky today. I'm ready to pull the handle and see what I get.
What protein are you hoping for?
Anything but salmon.
Ethnic cuisine?
I would love Greek.
Off you go. Come stand over.
Oh my God.
So protein first is salmon.
Wow, well done.
I got salmon, which I wasn't happy about, but my ingredients all like work together. As long as I get Greek.
Ethnic cuisine is?
I got Greek.
Greek, wow.
It's now Will's turn to gamble for ingredients.
Scallop. Wow. Mango and asparagus. What type of cuisine is?
Italian.
Italian.
I come from an Italian background.
Thank God.
Up next, Elizabeth.
Okay, off you go.
I'm definitely very familiar with Chinese. I currently work in an Asian restaurant.
Type of cuisine is?
Oh, I got Mexican.
Oh, damn.
Elizabeth got Mexican. I was totally jealous. I wanted Mexican so bad.
Okay, good. Type of cuisine is?
I hope I don't get Indian.
You got Indian.
Oh, God.
Elise will be cooking with?
Why tuna? Carrots. Beans.
Wow.
I don't even like beans. Kumquats I never seen before today.
What type of ethnic cuisine is?
Chinese. I have no Chinese food experience. None.
The Wheels of Fortune spin next for Paul.
Filet with eggplant.
I'm good with that.
Lenta. Grapefruit. And kale. Ethnic cuisine?
French.
Come on.
Yeah, I hit the jackpot, I think.
Come on, that is a jackpot. Well done. So, you've all got 45 minutes. Your time starts from now. Off you go. Good luck.
Thank you, Chef. Let's do this.
After the chef's inspirational culinary tour of New York, Chef Ramsay has designed this challenge to test their creativity with ethnic foods.
It's not French unless it has butter and cream.
Each chef must prepare an entree in the style of the cuisine featured on their coin using the five ingredients that they randomly earned playing slots.
What the heck is this?
A carrot, a yellow carrot.
Really? Not gonna lie, today's the first day I cooked something Chinese. Wow. It's like, okay, soy sauce?
What up to Sicilian olives?
The peppercorns?
15 minutes gone, 30 minutes to go.
Yes, chef.
Yes, chef.
When I think Jamaican, I think jerk, and jerk is spicy. So that's what I'm gonna do.
Bless you, bless you. You all right, girl?
Yeah, it's all these peppers over here.
Any more?
I think I'm good.
All right.
Last 5 minutes.
Holy
Jennifer.
Shit.
That's right.
Yes, chef.
Holy shit.
Time to go.
I'm gonna move.
May the spirit of Santo be with me.
I'm kind of freaking out right now.
I got plates for everybody. Here's your plate.
I have a bowl.
Let's go, start plating. Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and serve. Listen carefully. As you know, I'm looking for someone to emerge, a leader. So today, I'm gonna determine the winner of this challenge in a completely different way. That's right, never done this before.
I'm messing up. What the hell is going on?
King of the Hill. That's right, I'm gonna taste the dishes individually. The person with the best dish wins the challenge for their team. Got it?
Yes, chef.
It's time for everyone to start realizing that we're a group, but we're also individuals. And everyone needs to start to shine.
Tommy, let's go.
Go,
Tommy. Come
on, Tommy.
Up first is Tommy.
Put me on the spot.
With his attempt at Indian cuisine.
Let's do it.
So, what is it?
Okay, I did chicken roasted in the oven. What I was going for was like a mango curry.
Let's hope it tastes more Indian than it looks.
What do you think of the sauce?
It actually tastes delicious. Nice heat and a combination of spices. Mm-hmm. It tastes
I see that.
Indian.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Sit in the chair.
Good job, Tommy.
Elizabeth, let's go.
Chef said that this is going to be King of the Hill, but this is definitely going to be Queen of the Hill. My dish is going to win.
This is
New York strip. I garnished it with diced chorizo and cotechina cheese on top.
Okay. Steak slightly overcooked, but it tastes a lot better than it looks. And it tastes Mexican. Good job.
Thank you.
My big question is your dish more accomplished than Tommy's Indian-inspired dish? And the answer is... Congratulations, Elizabeth. Tommy, get off that chair.
Jobless.
Really good. Good job.
Thank you, chef. That's my chair. Tommy was just keeping it warm for me.
Natalie, talk to me.
I had pork, and the sauce is a guava paste, habanero coconut.
Jesus. Have you tasted the spices in there? Chef. God, it's almost bringing tears to my eyes. Is that hot for you?
I actually like it. I've tried to kind of sweeten it out.
That's way gone.
Okay.
Definitely will not be replacing Elizabeth.
Okay.
Back in line with your dish.
So good, Natalie.
Elizabeth, you're safe. Too much, Natalie.
It's all good, girl.
I thought my dish was good. I thought the spices were perfect.
Paul, let's go.
With Natalie's dish too hot to handle, it's up to Paul's French-inspired filet to regain the culinary throne for the blue team.
Meat's cooked perfectly. Love the idea behind the grapefruit in the Hollandaise, and that is French cuisine on a plate. It's delicious.
Thank you, chef.
And that's exactly what happens as he unseats Elizabeth.
Well done, Paulie.
Good job, Paulie.
Okay, Elise, let's go.
And now, Elise is ready to impress with her take on Chinese.
It's ahi tuna. It's seasoned with soy sauce.
Yeah, I like it. It's nice. Tuna's cooked perfectly.
Thank you, chef.
Take a seat. Congratulations.
Thank
Good
you,
job.
Chef.
And thus begins the reign of Queen Elise.
I'm the queen of the hill, and my dish is better than yours.
With the red team holding court, Will storms the castle with his take on Italian cuisine.
What is that?
I did prosciutto wrapped scallops. seared in olive oil and rendered prosciutto fat.
Delicious.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Will and Chef,
you're the king. Great job. Congratulations.
Good job, Will.
Good job.
Good job. Definitely the best dish I've tasted so far. If the competition ended right now, he'd win it for the blue team. But we have one more. Jennifer, let's go.
Yes, Chef. Oh my God, it's coming down to me and Will.
Jennifer,
New York and Boston, fighting to the end. That's what I'm excited about.
Tell me, what is it?
Pan-seared salmon with olives, feta cheese.
Salmon's cooked perfectly.
Thank you, Chef.
Wow, it's delicious.
Thank you, Chef.
It's a very tough call, this one. Two very good dishes. Tough, very tough. Okay, the king of the hill. And winning it for their team is... Jennifer.
Oh, fuck me.
Great job.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, good job.
Oh, my God, I won. I won the challenge. It's like, holy shit, I beat Will.
Good job, girl.
Boston beat out New York today.
Red team, clearly you sourced huge inspiration from your trip in New York. Well done. Okay, thanks to Jennifer. Your reward, since we're in Los Angeles, what better place to have great fun than at the beach?
Oh my God.
That's right, you're hitting the beach.
The beach!
Do you want to know what's happening at the beach?
Yes.
I'm not going to tell you, it's a surprise. What I will tell you is, you are going to love it. Well done, good job.
Thank you, Chef.
Thank you, Chef.
Thank you.
Blue team, tonight, Hell's Kitchen is open, which means you'll be prepping both kitchens ahead of tonight's service. It's going to be a long, hard, tedious afternoon.
Yes, Chef.
Red team, go and get into something a little bit more comfortable for a day on the beach.
Thank you, Chef.
Thank you, Chef.
Have a great time.
Beach, 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 beach,
bikini,
beach, 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 beach.
I have to shave.
Blue team, start off by cleaning down the kitchen. Let's go. Hurry up.
This is the fourth time in a game row. We got to sit here and prep up both freaking kitchens. Sucks.
Red team.
Shake that ass.
All right, start it off, Liz.
Ladies, shake that ass.
Woo! Beach, see ya.
Bye, guys.
That's what I'm talking about.
Keto goes to the beach.
Never seen anything like this before in my life.
Let's go!
Amazing.
Hey, hey, hey!
We're
gonna
get sand in our bottoms.
Crotches.
Are you serious?
Hey, ladies!
Oh my God.
It's Jay!
Welcome! Oh. Congratulations! You've won Zorbing!
What the heck is Zorbing?
Who wants to go first?
Not me.
But since no one else wants to do it, I'm a Zorb right now.
Ugh. Lay down and make sure you hold those straps.
Don't let go of whatever
it's
you do.
Easy.
This is bizarre.
Are we really pushing her?
Push!
Woo! Oh, God! Help! No way!
I pushed it with all my might.
They were kind of like thrilling screams. I kind of had fun with it. Just fucking do it already!
And push!
Oh my God! You guys, it'll hurt me and I'm gonna have the deafest in the service.
Push!
Dry minced onion. Should I actually mince that and put it out?
Dude, that's a dry ingredient.
I worry about Tommy all the time. He's dumb.
You really want to lose some fingers right now?
Well, and you can't fix dumb.
My wedgie is like the world's worst wedgie right now.
Ew.
They're back.
We went in a plastic bubble.
We went in a bubble and they pushed it and we spun and then we went on the beach.
I'm in a grumpy ass mood.
We had a good time.
I hate life.
It's just 30 minutes before dinner service, and the blue team is still prepping both kitchens.
Elise?
Yes?
I'm unwrapping your Wellingtons for you.
No problem.
But I'm not scoring them, though.
Cool.
Let's go, ladies. Yeah?
Yep.
Tasting spoons.
The service of your life.
Yes, chef. Tommy prepped the Wellingtons, but didn't score them. Like, whatever. I'll do it myself. I don't know why he did this like this. That's so stupid. I'm not liking how these Wellingtons are prepped.
James.
Yes, chef.
Let's go. Open Hell's Kitchen, please.
Yes, chef.
As usual, it's a full house for tonight's dinner service.
This is about pride, boys.
Hell yeah.
With only three chefs left in the red kitchen and four in the blue, each will be under heavy scrutiny tonight.
Order in, chef.
Let's go, ladies, yes?
Yes, chef.
You've been to New York, you've been inspired, you've seen the prize. Tonight is comeback night, right?
Yes, chef.
Here we go. Three scallops, one risotto.
Yes, chef!
Thank you, let's go.
6 minutes, Elizabeth.
6 minutes, heard. I am more motivated now than I have been during this whole competition. I just have to show chef that I, Elizabeth, can be an executive chef.
2.5 minutes, Elizabeth. Elizabeth?
While Elizabeth dreams of a bright future at BLT Steak in New York.
Elizabeth?
Over in the blue kitchen.
Tell me when to drop scallops, Paul.
Natalie is working hard to make that dream a reality.
Drop scallops.
Heard. In the last couple services, I've been struggling in the kitchen, and I think Chef Ramsay thinks that I'm green.
Two scallops, two risotto, working, yes?
Yes, chef. Going to the pass in 10 seconds, Paul.
I'm walking up, two scallops.
Let's go. I want to hear you, Natalie.
Yes, chef.
So I just have to get that wow dinner service in.
Wow.
Natalie, come here. All of you, come here. Look at that. Oh. You got cut one side. What's that? They're not even seared.
Completely raw scallop. I've been caught a few times with some mistakes here. I'm not going to tell you I'm perfect, but that's a major mistake.
I'll refire right
Hurry
now.
Hurry up. Get a grip, Natalie.
Yes, chef.
As Natalie races to refire her first appetizers in the red kitchen.
Service, nice sear in the scallops.
Thank you, chef.
I need two more scallops, please.
Elizabeth attempts to keep the momentum going with her next order of appetizers.
Hold on, wait, Jen, I need another scallop down?
Elizabeth, listen, yes.
How long? Scallops.
Elizabeth, talk.
3 minutes, chef.
Come on. We're getting slower. Elizabeth. Help her, Elise.
Yes, chef.
Jump in. I know it's hard for you to be encouraged to help somebody.
Chef. No, I'll
fucking jump in
yes,
then.
Yes, chef. Come on, girl. Get it together. A little bit of oil. Calm down. Elizabeth, she was so frazzled, it was making me feel anxiety because of the way she was.
Can you walk this up for me?
Yeah.
Let's go. Scallops. Let's go. Excellent service, please.
With an assist from Elise, appetizers are once again making their way out to the dining room.
Seriously, the best scallops I've ever tasted.
Meanwhile, the blue kitchen is finishing off appetizers.
Scallop.
Nice. Two risottos. Service, please.
And is now moving on to entrees.
Two entrees, one New York strip, one Wellington.
Yes, chef.
1 minute, Tommy, you got 30 seconds, homeboy.
All right. Tommy, put the onions on a towel when they come out of the fucking fryer.
I am now.
Put them on the towel.
Chef Scott yells at me all the time. I think he thinks I'm an idiot.
I swear to God, I will fucking beat you with that thing.
But I'm not gonna argue. You know, it's his job to be an angry dictator.
That's what I want.
But I know what a cook an onion ring.
Oh my God.
I'm telling him all night to put it on towel as soon as it comes out of the fryer. He just doesn't want to do it.
Hey, look, onion ring. Onion ring. Like a handful of onion worms. Soggy. Onion.
Fire another one right now, Chef.
Despite Tommy's troubles on the garnish station,
fish going to the pass.
The blue team has a steady flow of food leaving the kitchen.
Yummy, yummy.
And an hour into dinner service, both teams have fed half their diners.
Walking New York Strip.
Service.
So good.
Two sea bass.
I'm walking these two bass up right now.
And now it's up to Elizabeth to get the next order out.
What happened to them?
Elizabeth. Yeah. Come here, you. And you. Touch that there. Hold on a minute. Look. Look at that. Why are you doing this to yourself? It's dry.
Trash. I felt going into dinner service that I was going to do a really good job. Then I'm going through the motions of sucking. It was like this weird, like, zombie person took over Elizabeth.
But look at the state of you. Look, you're frazzled. Two bass? How long?
Talk to him.
Yes, I'll be 4 minutes on this cod, Chef.
That's a bass in ya.
I'm sorry, Chef. It's my fault, Chef. I'm very sorry, Chef.
Hey, come here.
I'm sorry that I'm freaking out. I called the cod bass.
Oh my God, Elizabeth, like, I don't know what you need to do, but you need to fucking wake up.
I'm sorry, Chef.
Come here, madam.
No, I'm fine.
Talk to me. You don't know the difference between a cod and a bass.
I don't like to fuck up. I feel like I've been fucking up too much tonight. It's like from the beginning.
There's nothing wrong. We're just dragging two bass.
Okay, I will calm down and I will be smooth for the rest of the service.
I feel like I'm losing my fucking mind.
You're frazzled, yeah? Big deep breath and come back.
It's like I'm in this like alternate universe where like I can't get anything done right at all.
What do I have working right now?
Two bass.
I see who's weakest now. You can't crumble like that. If you make a mistake, you gotta dust yourself off and fix it. Elizabeth is not good at doing that.
Elise, Wellington.
Yes, Chef.
Oh, come on.
What is that?
Elise. All of you, come here. Who chewed that? That's what you presented me. That's what you presented.
Apart, Chef. I'm sorry.
Fuck off, Elise.
Start again. Hey, you, bring me that tray here. All of you, come here.
Yes, sir.
She's complaining they're falling apart. When you score pastry that deep with a sharp knife, it falls apart.
I'm not gonna just sit here and take the blame myself. I have to do something.
How many of these have you screwed?
Chef, I did not score the first tray.
So who scored them then?
Tommy did.
Now you're blaming Tommy?
I'm just saying that I didn't score the first tray.
Go over there and fucking tell him then. I want to see what you say to him. Come here, you.
Problem with Elise is, Elise never admits that she's wrong. She always blames someone else.
Tell me
the truth.
She's got something to tell you.
That first tray of Wellingtons that you basted and scored, they all fell apart. Did you or did you not score the first tray of Wellingtons?
No. She's crazy. Don't come over bitching at me coming into my kitchen when we're working. I didn't even score the damn things.
I did not
Tommy
score them.
Right
I brushed
over them there in front of me before serves and scored and basted them.
No, I did not score them, and I'm not lying. Play the replay.
I'm unwrapping your Wellington for you.
No problem.
But I'm not scoring them, though.
Cool.
Hook me up to a polygraph. I'm telling you the damn truth.
If he scored them, why wouldn't he even scored ours?
Why didn't he score ours?
No, win a slice of Wellington.
Yo, that's some booty-ass shit, man. That girl coming over fucking trying to blame us because she can't cut Wellingtons. Man up. Own up to your mistakes.
Fucking pissed about these Wellingtons.
Elise, do you know the biggest problem with you? Yourself. Who are you going to blame? Carrie? Krupa? Jamie?
While the Red Kitchen's issues have left their diners without food, the Blue Team's diners have their food.
Hi, how is everything?
So fishy.
It's my brother.
Sorry about?
Although some of them wish they didn't.
Chef.
What's wrong?
It's really dry.
Blue Team.
Yeah.
Blue Team.
Yes, Chef.
Bass returned. Dry. I turned my back for 30 seconds. Hey, look, come here. Hey, madam.
Yes, Chef.
I'm not fucking around now.
I know, Chef.
Touch that. Yeah, dry. Overseer.
I don't know what I'm doing.
Hey, you've hit the nail on the head there. You don't know what you're doing. It's not good enough.
I'm worried about undercooking them, so I'm overcooking them.
Chef.
Oh, no.
They're rubbery.
Oh, come on.
Table 23, table 21, table 22. Every single table on the blue side is complaining about the sea bass tonight. Everybody said it's dry.
They're right. You can't cook fish.
I can cook fish.
So the customers are lying?
No, Chef.
The day we, as chefs, start blaming customers.
No, Chef, I'm not blaming customers. No. It's frustrating and embarrassing because I'm not an idiot. I know how to cook fish. I really just don't know what was going on. Sorry, guys.
None of that shit. Get your head in the game. Keep pumping until the last goddamn ticket's out.
While Natalie's sea bass has left diners on the blue side unsatisfied, the diners on the red side are hoping Elizabeth's sea bass will hit the spot.
Two bass on New York trip to how long?
I need 4 minutes.
You're not even checking with me, yo.
Jennifer, can you get them together?
I'm trying.
Can you get them together?
You need to drive the ticket, Elise.
I said 2 minutes. 2 minutes, Liz.
My bass is not going to be done in 2 minutes.
I want to leave this group, but it's hard when you have Elise who doesn't listen. You guys need to work together right
she
now.
She asked me to hold it back. The only
okay.
thing would say it was me.
And Elizabeth that just has no confidence. How long, Elizabeth?
I need...
Talk. How long?
How long?
Everybody's gonna get mad at me.
How long do you need?
I need 5 minutes. Five minutes.
5 minutes now? You said 4 minutes. 4 minutes ago.
I need 5 minutes. It's not gonna be done.
These fucking sea basses are taking so long to cook.
It's fucking raw in the middle.
So I'm trying to rush it, but there is no more way to rush it.
Where's the bass?
The two
bass. Holy crap. All of you, come here.
Oh, come on.
Look, it's raw.
Raw. You're going down in flames, chick.
Elizabeth, you took twice as long for that table.
Chef, I feel like I had that fish down for like 10 minutes. I don't know.
You're blaming the fish.
I didn't want to drag it anymore.
Get it back in the pan. Stop being a pathetic little wimp. Come on, let's go.
Chef.
And you still haven't got the fucking table out. New York strip, is that ready or?
I need a minute on my,
Come on then, let's go.
Yes, chef.
So you've sliced it and it's not cooked.
It needs like seconds.
So you take one slice off, don't you stop there and put it back in whole. Does it dry out when you've sliced it? Look, she just shakes her head. Hold on. Cry time?
No. Chef thinks that I'm the one behind the eight ball, but I was trying to time with Elizabeth and she kept asking for more time,
Excuse me.
Please. I was trying to look out for the team and wait for her. The New York Strip.
Unbelievable. Hey, just stop. This is ridiculous.
Oh my God, we're gonna get so thrown out of here.
Is this the one you sliced?
Yes, chef.
It's dry. What are you doing? You've been to New York. You've had your hands on the prize. This is like night one in here.
No, chef.
And you, Elizabeth, you can't time and you can't talk to anybody. You've given up over there.
No, chef.
You and you, fuck off out of here. Get out. Take that with you. Just leave me alone. Get out of here, both of you. Fuck off up to the dorm. Hey, you, pick that fucking thing up. You want to serve shit, overcook me, now start kicking a bin. Wow. Un-fucking-believable. Get out. Fuck off. Pathetic. Embarrassing. Jennifer?
Yes, chef.
You're on your own.
Yes, chef.
One card, two New York strip, one Wellington, yes?
Yes, chef.
How long, please, Andy?
Yep. On those strips, I got at least 7 minutes.
Don't worry.
You got everything, Jen?
Yep, cod, mashed potatoes, yep.
We're 8 minutes out, okay?
Yes, chef. Oh my God, working with Chef Ramsay alone was almost nerve-wracking, but it was also exciting.
4 minutes to the window, yes?
Yep, 4 minutes, chef.
Yeah.
He was calling out ticket times, waiting for me to respond. At one point, he says to me, I'm slicing.
30 seconds starting to slice.
Walking with garnish.
Yep.
30 seconds. It kind of showed me like what we're supposed to be doing. I am absolutely the luckiest girl in the world to be able to work with Chef Ramsay right now. Walking with two cod.
With the last entrees served.
Enjoy.
Looks good, John.
And both kitchens delivering desserts. A very rough night in Hell's Kitchen.
It's an explosion of chocolate.
Oh my God, that's good.
Is finally over.
Clear down. Switch off.
Yes, chef.
I've decided from now on in that I will not select a winning team unless I get a perfect service. And trust me, I did not get one from either team tonight. Both teams get back upstairs to the dorm and come to a consensus on the one individual that should be leaving your team to make you more dynamic. Get upstairs.
I obviously want to do really well here and I'm not having those perfect services like I should be having. This could be my last night here. It's upsetting.
Anybody want to start?
I think we all know.
What's that?
I mean, I know I need to go up, so.
Oh, don't start crying, girl.
Yeah, chill out, baby.
Natalie, come on. Come here. Come on.
If I go up there, he's going to send me home.
You don't know that.
Oh, no, he fucking goes home tonight.
Natalie had a really bad service tonight, but I feel that Elise should go home tonight because Elise is like cancer. Like if I had a vote, my vote would be for Elise.
I couldn't believe she came in and started yelling at me about a Wellington, but I'm trying to concentrate.
And Chef Ramsay called her out for scoring them too deep and they're falling apart. And she's still trying to argue when she had raw Wellingtons.
I hope she goes home tonight.
Make it short and sweet. What's your decision?
God, I don't know what to do. Do I base it off of tonight or do I base it on overall?
Tonight.
Okay, just for the record, Chef did not say to base your decision on tonight's performance.
I know.
He said, I'm making your team stronger.
Right now, tonight, I felt like, Elizabeth, you fucking lost it. But overall?
I think my overall performance, it just shows in my nominations that I have not been up yet.
I just feel like Elizabeth was so frustrated. It was hard to look at her. It was hard to time stuff.
I'm not denying you this. This is why I'm talking
about it. It was hard for me. It was hard for me.
You know I don't play the blame game.
You can just put me up.
You play it all the way up to the end.
I'm telling it like it is.
You'll continue to blame until the end.
If you want to put me up, put me up.
I don't know who I want to put up, okay? Give me a minute, all right?
I'm getting nervous because you're not getting better. Will, the nominee and why?
Natalie, chef. She couldn't cook fish tonight.
Jennifer, the nominee and why, please.
Least chef. Her biggest problem is she doesn't admit mistakes. She's first to blame everyone else except herself.
Elise, Natalie, step forward, please.
Keep your head up, Natalie.
Natalie, tell me why you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen.
I'm a talented chef. I deserve to be here. I worked my ass off to get here. I've worked my ass off my entire life. I know I'm green. I know I have a lot to learn. But I know that in the end, I can be what BLT's looking for.
It's your third time up here. I can't inspire you anymore. There are no places left to hide. Elise, I cannot believe you had the audacity to blame Tommy for your mess. When are you ever going to step up and...
Right now.
...take responsibility?
Right now.
Oh,
right
really?
Right now.
You need to go home. You have a family
no,
at home.
No, I don't want to go home. If I don't shine on my next service and perform perfectly, then I'll throw myself out of here. Opportunities like this don't come where I'm from, and I'm very thankful to be here. I can really cook, chef, and I'm just not ready to go until I prove that.
Okay. The person leaving Hell's Kitchen is...
Did you or did you not score the first tray of Wellington?
No.
Oh, come
table
on.
Table 23, table 21. Every single table on the blue side is complaining about the sea bass tonight.
I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing.
You hit the nail on the head there. Natalie, please take off your jacket. Look at me. Continue cooking. Big heart. Love the energy. But you are not ready to run BLT Steak New York. Please give me your jacket. Thank you for the effort. And do not stop. Okay? Do not stop.
Keep your head up, Natalie.
Come on, guys. Keep talking to each other. To Wellington, chef.
Natalie, good job.
I came to Hell's Kitchen to prove to myself that I'm a good chef.
You got butternut squash puree.
Yes, I do.
Joining the blue team, Natalie.
I just couldn't imagine sharing an experience like this with anyone other than the blue team.
No more fucking grapes! I'm not doing it anymore!
One, two, three, blue!
Hell's Kitchen was one of the hardest things I've ever done in my life.
I have a teammate that thinks I was trying to fuck him on purpose.
I came in here with the attitude that I could do it, and I never stopped having that attitude.
That's awesome.
It's what I do, boys.
It's definitely disappointing. I obviously came here to win, and deep down, I know I could have done it.
Each and every one of you, I've seen glimpses of brilliance, but I've got to see that level of inspiration. Got it?
Yes, chef!
Get out of here.
Elise should have gone home. I know she's gonna wake up tomorrow and she's gonna throw me or Elizabeth under the bus. It's gonna be Groundhog Day all over again.
There's only three people in each kitchen. No reason to blame anybody else. There's no excuses anymore. So now it's put up or shut up.
Thank you, Chef Ramsay, for giving me another day in hell. I'm gonna step up my game 200% because at this point, I don't feel like anyone else is standing in my way but myself.
Natalie was lucky enough to get to see BLT Steak in New York. She may get to see it again as a customer.
Next time on Hell's Kitchen. the restaurant is closed for a very special event.
Never before have we done something as important as tonight's charity event.
And Chef Ramsay wants a perfect evening for his VIP guests.
I'm so embarrassed! Tommy!
I want to smack Tommy in the face!
But can the chefs work together?
Let me do my thing.
I'm not going to let you do something that's wrong.
Or will it be Chef Ramsay's most humiliating dinner service yet?
Why? Why tonight?
Look at that! Yeah.
With the coveted black jackets going to the survivors.
What the hell is wrong with you guys?
Trying to sabotage me?
She's fucking with the wrong person.
The chefs will stop at nothing.
Back off.
And I mean nothing.
War's on.
What?
To make it to the final five.
Tonight, all of you can be leaving this fucking competition
on an episode unlike any other.
And get ready to plea for your life.
Are you fucking kidding me?
That's next time on Hell's Kitchen.